I'm Adil Beg. So my question is, the objective of Niti Aayog has 13 objectives when it was created. The third objective speaks to develop mechanism to formulate credible plans at the village level and aggregate these progressively at higher levels of government. So what has been done in this particular area? How the village level plans have been aggregated to higher levels? So the bottom up approach. And my second question is about the Make in India scheme. We are facing a scenario of jobless growth. So in the jobless growth, we shifted from primary to tertiary. On one side, we are having this new technologies where jobs are at the threat, and we are not having jobs, and the climate change another area. So how we are going to balance this by, in the manufacturing growth?
Okay. On aggregate village level planning, it's a mandate that we have not been able to adapt to just now. And we are trying to do this with the 15th Finance Commission. We've had two meetings with them, because the problem simply is that the village, the local government is just simply starved of resources. So there is, even if you make those village plans, you won't get very much far. So, but Niti Aayog is engaged with the 15th Finance Commission to try and make sure that a reasonable amount of resources goes down to the village level. And so we have not been able to do this bottom-up, you know, planning. Also, it's a big issue because of the center-state relations, you know, in the sense that while all the chief ministers are the members of the governing council of Niti Aayog, you know, we have to be very careful about the state's own fiscal and administrative sovereignty as to what we can do with it. So that, you know, it's a very complex issue. So it's not an objective that can be achieved within the first 4 years. You know, after all, the Niti Aayog did come in. On the jobless growth and on the new technology and etc., very large issues. But let me assure you that, one, we've come out with a strategy paper on artificial intelligence. We are doing another paper on blockchains. We are very conscious of what's happening in the Industry 4.0. But we are also very sure that we have to face up those these challenges head on, because we have to not let industrial progress or technology and employment become a trade-off, because we can't afford that. But I think you must recognize that the same sort of questions came up when I was, well, older than you, in the late 80s, when Rajiv Gandhi wanted to bring in laptops and computers in the banks. So there's always this Luddite versus progression, you know, sort of argument. But we need to take that on board. And this is, but one of the things, and I'll sort of stop here, is that our approach is that if we can make the MSME, the small and not the micro, the small and medium enterprises, the absorbers of new technology, and make this, I just had a long, big meeting yesterday on that. If we can create the absorptive capacity in that segment of our industry and of our, you know, and make them the absorbers of new technology, so that they become much more integrated with global and regional production chains, then this trade-off could perhaps be, you know, warded off, because the numbers, that scale is huge, you know, and the scale is huge. But for that, and I know I'm being long-winded, what you need is this, but this touches on the answer to something else. It completely impinges on what we do with our education and our skill formation. And that is still not where we should be. It's much below where we should be. And I think that is where, if I had another stint, my greatest focus will be on malnutrition on the one hand, because you can't teach a child whose brain is not developed, and on education on the other. And so that's the, because human capital is what we have more than anything else, and that's what we need to develop on. But, and then there's a third question then,